Hey guys and girls, welcome back. This time I'm taking another look at the Spawn White Vision trading cards. As promised, I bought two more boxes. I will go through this box rather quickly this time. Last time I noticed that the chase cards are always the first card in the pack, and since I'm only missing a few base cards, I will look for those afterwards. If you want to see a more detailed break, I will leave a link to the first break at the end of the video. As you can see, this is another box that has been used for soccer practice, but on the other hand, I really got this for very cheap. I only paid 22 euros for the box, or 23 euros plus a little bit of shipping, which is super cheap for these. And yeah, the seller actually tried to raise the price afterwards, and right off the bat I have a pulled a chase card. So here we have the Violator Mobile, which is the Violator Monster Rig, which is one of the toy chase cards, so that's neat. I'm also missing that. And as you can see, the cards, gonna go through the first pack, they come out quite nicely. Luckily they're not sticky, but I'm not going through the individual base cards again, just be on the lookout for the chase cards. And afterwards I will check if I've got the base set complete, and then we're gonna do a full recap. And if I can't complete the base set with this box, I'm gonna do the second box directly afterwards within this video. So here's right off the bat the next toy chase card, which is the Spawn Mobile. Also another one that I was missing from the first box, and these seem to be a little bit sticky, but so far I had no problems with them whatsoever. Yeah, I checked that afterwards when I put them in the binder. Yeah, what I was talking about, so the seller, I bought these. Oh, and directly another chase card, Salmon Twitch by Joe Chiodo, one of the painted chase cards. Really nice. So the I bought these for 23 euros, both boxes together, and the seller at one time had a really large amount of these boxes, but now he's about to sell out. And again, directly another painted chase card, Mel Bolger P8. I believe that's a duplicate. I think I pulled this in the previous box. And so he sent me an email that something went wrong with the payment, and that eBay had server problems whatsoever, and if I could cancel the transaction. So here we have the just base cards. And then I checked my PayPal account, and there was no difference. I paid exactly, or PayPal certainly sent the right amount of money to him. And then I noticed that he had changed the auction from 22 or 23 euros buy it now to 39 euros buy it now. And so he was trying to fuck me over in a way. So I decided to not cancel my purchase and told him that I didn't know what he was talking about, and that PayPal sent him the right amount of money, and Yeah. And then he needed to send me the boxes for the price I had bought them for. I mean, I would have paid 39 euros. I would have bought only one box then, which would have been still an acceptable price. But the way he tried to trick me, I wasn't very pleased with that. So I did not cancel the purchase and got the boxes for the price I bought them for. So all base cards, as you can see, it's a bit weird pulling four chase cards from the first four packs. So this is gonna be a rather quick one, and then I'm gonna go into the recap where I show off hopefully the full base set, or I assume three boxes should be enough to complete the base set if I haven't complete, if it isn't complete after this box. I will do the next box directly after this one and put them in one video. Again, no chase card. Really nice would be if I could pull the chrome chase card, but that's a super rare card, which is 1 in 306 packs. So I'm not expecting to find that one. Again, no chase card. And yeah, the artwork on the set is really nice, in my opinion. All exclusive artwork as far as I can tell, and it basically documents the first, I think, 25 issues of Spawn. But Todd McFarlane didn't use artwork from the books themselves, and instead hired other artists to basically redo some of the images. Very nice. Medieval Spawn versus Violator, but also simple base card. So put it aside. Ooh, what's this? Faced the wrong side. Overkill painted chase card. That's also one I think I pulled in the previous box. But obviously I have to check, which I'll do afterwards. The Todd McFarlane face shot checklist. That's something I really like. It's always cool when they put the creators in the set too. Only seen that once before, which was in a Evil Ernie trading card set. Love this Violator clown by Sam Keith. And this one is also very nice. I always forget who the artist was. Jay Lee. And yeah, the only other set I know of is, I think, Evil Ernie Series 1, which had face shots of Brian Pulido and Steven Hughes, who created the character. And maybe you could count the Stan Lee card from the first Marvel Universe series, but otherwise the best you can get is that the artist is mentioned on the back of the card. And even that's not a regular occurrence. Oh, and here we have a Todd McFarlane art chase card, TG2. Nice Spawn from him. And these are only one per box. And I think that's one I haven't seen. I'm not exactly sure which one I pulled in the previous box, but I don't think it was that one. Oh, come on. Base cards. Card in this one, okay. It's weird. Let's see, but nothing out of the ordinary in this pack. Some more base cards, just showing off a few of them. Nice painted artwork of Al Simmons and his wife, or not, his wife and a new husband, Terry Fitzgerald, or his widow in that case, since, or maybe I got something wrong, maybe, I don't know, it's been a long time since I've read anything Spawn related. Only base cards. More base cards. I think I probably have pulled the chase cards I can find in this box, I think. So, just left. Let's just go through the last packs and hopefully to the recap. More base cards. Nothing out of the ordinary. Joe Quesada Spawn. Some really great artists in this set. It's also an awesome rendition of Spawn. That's from Scott Clark and Sal Regla. So, let's see. Last four packs. Tremor again on the top. Nothing special here. And the last prep pack, which will probably also not have anything special. And it's the other checklist, so nothing too special in this box. So now I'm gonna check and then we'll get hopefully to the recap. Okay, so without checking, I decided to do the second box immediately. Why let it wait? And man, these boxes are messed up. If I wouldn't have gotten them so cheap, I would be rather pissed. So, and again, I'm only going to check for the chase cards. And then we're gonna do a recap with the full base set afterwards, which I think I should have complete after this second box, or third box. Tremor again on the top. And another toy figure, Malbolgia, a toy card, Malbolgia, that's nice. That's another one that I'm still missing. Base card. Another base card on the top. Oh, wow, another interesting art chase card that I haven't seen before. That's nice. Violator. Oh, Bill Sienkiewicz. Nice. And another Tremor on top of the pack. Wow. And another interesting painted card again by Bill Sienkiewicz. Violator in his clown form. Really interesting artwork from him. I haven't seen this style from Bill Sienkiewicz before. Spawn versus Tremor on top. Malbolgia. Just overkill. Medieval Spawn. Spawn with random demons. Another interesting Spawn base. Again, the awesome Jay Lee Spawn, my favorite card from the set. And again, this nice card. The family at home. Spawn and random dude. Another base. Nice. Angela by J. Scott Campbell. And another Bill Sienkiewicz painted art card, Redeemer. Very nice. I think that's all cards I'm missing. And the other spawn, Todd, new art card. Violator GG1 might be the one I pulled in the first box, but we'll see. Come on. And the checklist with the man himself again. And the spawn mobile again. Ah, that's not a duplicate, but that was bound to happen. I wasn't expecting to get that lucky on the chase cards. And medieval spawn again, painted art by Bill Sienkiewicz. Minor damage seems to be badly cut. Nice. Although I think that's the one I also pulled in the first box I broke. Tremor again. I think that's probably not a lot of chase cards left in this medieval spawn. Nice image. Random spawn. The spawn checklist again. Spawn playing with his kit. Nothing interesting. Spawn versus Tremor again. Spawn versus Violator again, medieval spawn. Last three packs. I don't think there's anything special in here, and then we're gonna go to the full recap. Well, I'll show you the base set and give you my opinions on this set. Spoilers, I really like it. Even though I'm not really a huge fan of Spawn. Okay, so that's it for box number 3. So after breaking 3 of the Spawn White Vision trading cards, I was able to complete the 150 card base set. I may have even completed it after breaking the second box, but I didn't really bother to check because I wanted to look for some more chase cards. And overall, I really liked the set, even though I'm not a fan of Spawn. And mostly because there's a few interesting concepts or ideas with this set that I haven't seen before done in other sets. And mostly, obviously, it's the size of the cards. These White Vision trading cards are not done nowadays, at least as far as I know. And even in the 90s, it was rather rare to see these sizes of cards. And the other one is the concept of the set itself, because every 6-card page you see basically retells the story of one issue of Spawn. And all 25 pages complete the story of the first 25 issues of Spawn. So obviously on the first page we have issue 1. And I also really like that there's a lot of different and interesting artists on this set. I think most of the artwork is exclusive to the card set, but I'm not really sure on that. There's a few McFarlane cards in this base set that may have been taken from the comic books. So right off the bat, on the first page, we have artists like Bill Sienkiewicz and Tim Sale, which I really like. And on the second page, we have artists like Sam Keith, Jim Lee, J. Scott Campbell, and yeah, really interesting artwork. Here's one of the Todd McFarlane cards. And like I said, each page represents one comic book. And on the back of the cards, it retells the story of the book. So this would be issue 3 and issue 4. And some really cool artwork, in my opinion. For example, this is a really cool image, in my opinion, by Ron Lim. And it's Violator and Spawn dislocating their arms and throwing them at the viewer, you might say. So it's really, really a neat set. If you're a fan of Spawn, I would highly suggest this set. Here, for example, is Walt Simonson, who I wasn't expecting to see a card of in this set. Would be cool if he would have done a Spawn card and not just a mostly random goon cards, but whatever. And yeah, mostly really cool artwork. Here's, for example, another image by Todd McFarlane, Spawn vs. Overkill. Really neat one. And yeah, like I said, the artwork fits very nicely on the cards. Here we have some Tony Harris artwork, these two cards, and some more J. Scott Campbell. A really cool Angela by Jim Lee. And these two medieval Spawns also look very nice. So I highly suggest this set if you're a fan of Spawn. Or I highly recommend this set. Some very cool artworks. Especially the images of Spawn look very nice. Tony Harris and Tim Bradstreet. My favorite Spawn card in this set, or at least in the base set, is this Jay Lee Spawn. Some cool looking Violator cards. More medieval Spawns. Violator decapitated. The Redeemer. Really nice looking cards. And and I don't know how hard to find they are nowadays. I had the luck of finding 3 boxes from a German seller for a rather good price. I paid like 29 euros per box, so that's pretty cheap. And I was a little bit lucky, the boxes were in terrible shape, but it didn't reflect too much on the cards. I mean, one thing you definitely have to look out for is that the cards are very badly centered, most of them at least. Like this Overkill, for example. I mean, I could see if I can find a better centered one, but maybe I'll revisit my duplicates. But for the sake of showing you the base set, I think this is good enough. And this is also a card I really like, Joe Quesada and Jimmy Permiotti. Really nice spawn again. Also this one by Sal Regler, and who was the other artist, Scott Clark. Really nice. And then we get to the chase cards and the checklist. So these two cards are the checklists. I also think it's a cool idea that Todd McFarlane put his own image on one of the checklists. I think that's something I would like to see a little bit more, at least on sets that are done by single artists. And this nice checklist is artwork by Michael Golden, who's also a really cool comic book artist. And like I said, then we get to the chase cards. So here are 3 of the Todd McFarlane, I think they're called Todd McFarlane New Art cards. These are 1 per box, and I managed to get lucky and didn't get a duplicate on those. There's only 4 different ones of them, so that's definitely neat. And then we get to the painted chase cards. There's 12 different of those. I did get a few duplicates on those, but what's really interesting here, at least to me, are the first 5 ones you see here. They are all artwork by Bill Sienkiewicz, which I'm a big fan of. And the reason these are interesting to me is that they all seem to be done digitally, which is something I haven't seen of Bill Sienkiewicz so far, at least not in this capacity. This looks very different from his regular artwork. There's a few Daredevil and Elektra covers and stuff that come to mind, and these definitely don't look like the style he uses for those. Then we have some painted cards by Joe Chiodo. These 2 are also painted by Joe Chiodo. The artist on this one was Joe Phillips. And then the next chase card set would be the toy line, or the Spawn toys, which are basically the first toys or prototypes Todd McFarlane put out for his Spawn line. And to me, this is a really weird chase card set. I mean, promoting your own toy line in your comic book related trading card set seems a bit cheap to me, and also these don't look that great because they're photographic, but yeah, whatever. And then there's 2 more which are even weirder, I feel, like the Violator car and the Spawn mobile, which is really weird. And I did really get lucky, because I pulled the one super rare card, which is the Todd Chrome card. Let's get it out of here so I can show it to you. Oh, it's not that easy. Come on. And the weird thing about this is, first off, I didn't notice that I pulled it, because usually the chase cards were always on top of the pack, so you could immediately see if you pulled a chase card or not, but this was sandwiched somewhere in between. And I even thought that this may be a misprint because it looks so weird, but I checked online and this is what the card is supposed to look like. And the interesting thing is that the image only comes up when you hold it against a light source. So let me try that out so you can I don't know how this comes off on the camera. Otherwise, it just looks like a black outline of Spawn. And yeah, still very neat that I pulled this card, because it's basically a one in 240 packs, so quite hard to find. I'm really happy with that. And finally, I just put three of the duplicate painted artwork cards on the bottom row, so the last page is filled up. And yeah, that's basically it with this set. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and maybe until next time. Bye-bye.